You're watching Diga's Gopi TV. I'm Elaine Stenson. Currencies and markets have fallen in emerging economies this year. In line with other emerging markets, India has been cutting its holdings of US treasuries. I'm joined on the line now by Vladimir Vaino from Sberbank in Slovakia. Vladimir, why do you think there's a need for India to draw down reserves?
First of all, the case of India is relatively specific. The thing is that as the global markets were discussing the impact of the Fed tapering of its easy monetary policy, some of the emerging markets were hit with hit negatively. That was also the case of India, which had experienced depreciation of its currency during the summer months, which explains why the central bank had to draw down part of its reserves to use it to support the currency, and hence it lowered the holding of its government treasuries. But in general, one has to keep in mind that even the official foreign exchange reserves are being invested, among other goals, with an aim of maximizing or at least achieving profit. And since it has become clear early this spring that the treasuries have hit their bottom in terms of yields, the risk for increase in yields and decline, corresponding decline in the prices, has caused the tapering of the purchases of official accounts, which means the foreign central banks. The net inflow into treasury bonds and notes has been negative ever since.
While China, the largest foreign holder of U.S. treasuries, cut its holding between July and August. What are the potential reasons for this, in your opinion?
One has to keep in mind the overall development of the Chinese foreign exchange reserves, which have hit the all-time high in April this year at 3.53 trillion, and have slightly declined ever since, partly reflecting the fact that China has allowed its currency to appreciate over the past weeks. We have seen the record high levels of the exchange rates of Chinese currency vis-a-vis U.S. dollar, which explains also the lower inflow of the new foreign exchange reserves and lower purchase of the U.S. Treasury bonds. But nevertheless, one has to view this, even this story of China, in with a bit of a perspective when we look at the long-term development. The total Chinese holdings of the treasuries are still over 100 billion higher than they were this time a year ago. And in general, one has to be careful about not reading too much into monthly fluctuations and into developments of foreign exchange reserves. Compared to August 2012, the total official holdings of U.S. treasuries remain some 16 billion U.S. dollars higher. This stood at the end of August at 3.9 trillion U.S. dollars.
This week, the IMF gave a bleak outlook for emerging market economies, slashing its growth forecasts, putting this down to tightening capacity constraints, falling commodity prices, less policy support, and slowing credit growth. But not everyone is convinced that it's all doom and gloom for the emerging world. What's your response to this?
One has to be careful. I think over the past few years, we have read too much into this extraordinary monetary stimulus as being a major contributor to growth. One has to keep in mind that especially in emerging economies, it is the private entrepreneurial activity, the private companies and investors seeking profitable opportunities, which are the most important drivers of growth. I would not read too much into the anticipated effect of potential gradual end of the loose monetary policy in the developed economies as having such a detrimental effect on the emerging markets. Basically, the underlying fundamentals when it comes to the investment opportunities and developing entrepreneurial capacity is something that will still propel the emerging economies, even at a lower pace, but still ahead and significantly faster growth compared to the developed markets. Also, because we got used to this extraordinary monetary stimulus for so long, I think the tapering of the extra loose monetary policy in the developed markets in the U.S. is something that we haven't experienced yet, and therefore part of the negative expectation associated with the effect of tapering of the extra loose monetary policy on the real economy might be over-exaggerated.
Vladimir, thank you for joining me on the line today. And that's all for me for now, but the team will be back with more interviews, so keep clicking back for more. Bye for now.